Hello friends, in this video we discuss about the types of polarization and types of dielectric material. So objective of this video is to understand and study the types of polarization and types of dielectric materials. Okay, one more point is there, that is frequency and temperature dependence of dielectric materials. Okay, so first we'll discuss about the types of polarization. So this polarization divides into three types. First one is the electronic polarization. So another name of this type of polarization is atomic polarization. Now here we can see two figures. First shows absence of electric field, what happen, and in the presence of electric field, what happen. So when the electric field is absent, then we can see the nucleus is at the center, okay, and electron is revolving around the nucleus, okay, and when we apply the electric field, then this nucleus moves away from the electric field and this electron cloud moves towards the electric field. Understood? And due to this reason, what happen, there is a net displacement and it is less than the dimensions of the atom, and hence such type of this polarization called as a electronic polarization. Understood? Now here we can see the dipole moment is proportional to the magnitude of the field strength and is given by mu e is equal to alpha e into capital E. Now this alpha e represent the electronic polarizability constant and capital E is nothing but the applied electric field. Understood? Now the second type of the polarization is ionic polarization. So this type of polarization produced by relative displacement between the positive and negative ions. Okay, according to name, this type of polarization occurs only in ionic crystals like NaCl, KCl, etc. Okay, now this figure shows the displacement of the ions due to external electric field. Now first figure shows there is no applied field is there, and the second figure shows when we apply the electric field. Okay, so here when we or in the absence of the electric field, what happen, there is no net polarization inside the material. Okay, because the dipole moment of negative ion and positive ion cancel with each other. Okay, and when we apply the electric field, then ion becomes displaced, which results into a induced polarization. Understood? Now third type of polarization is orientation polarization. Now this orientation polarization occurs in polar substances. These substances exhibit dipole moment even in the absence of external electric field. Due to random orientation of the dipoles or molecules, the net dipole moment is zero. Now here we can see the figures. First figure where the applied field is zero. Second figure shows the applied field is weak, and in third figure the applied field is very strong. Okay, so here what happened, due to a random orientation of the dipole, net dipole moment is zero. Understood? Okay, and when we apply the strong electric field to the material, then this dipole rotate about their axis of symmetry and try to align with the direction of the applied field. Understood? Now this slide shows types of dielectric material. Now this dielectrics divides into three parts. First one is solid dielectrics, second one is the liquid dielectrics, and third one is the gaseous dielectrics. Okay, now this solid dielectrics again divided into three types. First one is the elementary dielectrics, second one is the non-polar ionic dielectrics, and third one is the polar dielectrics. Now elementary dielectric means if the solid contains only one type of the atom. Understood? Or we can say that this type of dielectrics exhibit only electronic polarization called as a elementary solid dielectrics. Now here we can see the examples of the elementary dielectrics. Understood? Now second type of the solid dielectrics is non-polar ionic dielectrics. Okay, now here in this case of dielectrics, there is more than one type of atom is there, but no permanent dipole is there, so it is called as a ionic non-polar dielectrics. Now here we can see the examples of non-polar ionic dielectrics. Understood? Now third type of solid dielectrics is polar dielectrics. Now what happen in polar dielectrics? All type of polarizations are present here. Okay, and this solid has a permanent dipole moment, and hence it is known as a polar dielectric materials. Understood? Now these are the examples. Okay, now second type of dielectrics is liquid dielectrics. Now again, liquid dielectrics divide into three types: mineral oils, synthetic oil, miscellaneous oil. Okay, now here the mineral oil is obtained from the crude petroleum by distillation. Okay, so it is used as a coolant in transformer. Okay, second type of liquid dielectrics is synthetic oil. Now this synthetic oil is cheap and it is designed in laboratories. Okay, so it is used in a high tension transformer for cooling purpose. Okay, and third type, that is miscellaneous oil. So it is silicon liquid and vegetable oils. It has high cost compared to other oils. It is used in high tension transformer. Okay, now third type of dielectrics, that is gaseous dielectrics. It divides into four types: air, nitrogen, sulfur hexafluoride and hydrogen. Understood? Now we discuss about the air. So we know that air is naturally available gas. Its dielectric constant is 1. It is used for electrical insulation. Ionization of air is 0 and resistivity is infinity. So it is used in long range electrical transmission and in air capacitor. Understood? Now second type of gaseous dielectrics is nitrogen. So this nitrogen is used to prevent oxidation. Okay, here this nitrogen is used to prevent the oxidation when it is chemically inert. So it is used in high voltage cables or in transformers, etc. Now third type is sulfur hexafluoride. So it is better than air and nitrogen, having dielectric strength is 2.3 times higher than this. Okay, so it is non-toxic, non-flammable and chemically inert. And last type of gaseous dielectrics, that is hydrogen. Okay, so it has better dielectric strength, so it is used in large generator, high voltage cables, etc. Now we'll discuss about the temperature and frequency dependence of dielectric material. Now the dielectric properties like polarization, dielectric constant, dielectric loss, all these properties depends upon the frequency of applied electric field and temperature. Okay, now what happens when we apply the electric field to the dielectric material? So when we apply the electric field to the dielectric material, the polarization of material is function of time, and that can be we can write like this: P of t is equal to P of 1 minus exponential in bracket minus t divided by tau r, give equation number 1. Here this P represent maximum polarization attained due to electric field. This tau r is nothing but the relaxation time. Okay, so for particularly this polarization process, this relaxation time is nothing but the average time between the molecular collision under the application of electric field. Understood? Now next one. Now here interfacial, or we can say that space charge polarization, occurs when there is an addition of charge at an interface between two materials or between two regions within a material because of an external field. Okay, it occurs at very low frequency. Okay, this is slowest process compared to other polarization. The orientation polarization is faster than space charge polarization. The ionic polarization occur at 1013 Hz frequency and it is faster than orientation and space charge polarization. Okay, and the electronic polarization occurs at 1015 Hz frequency and it is faster than other types of polarization. Now here, temperature dependence. Now in the presence of electric field, the alignment of the dipoles are changed. Means when we apply the electric field to the material, then the dipoles having direction or alignment of the dipoles are changed. So when we increase the temperature, the dielectric constant decreases. And this happens because of alignment of dipoles are disrupted. Understood? So other type of polarization are not affected by temperature. Thus, the values of this dielectric constant remains unchanged with the change in temperature. Now last point we'll discuss relation between dielectric constant K and dielectric susceptibility psi. Okay, so we know that on the electric displacement D is equal to epsilon 0 into E plus P. Here give equation number 1. This D is nothing but the electric displacement. Epsilon 0 indicates permittivity of free space. This capital E indicates applied electric field. And this P is nothing but the polarization produced in dielectrics. Okay. Now after that, polarization of material we can write P is equal to epsilon 0 into psi E into E. Give equation number 2. Okay. Now put the values of this P in this equation. We get capital D is equal to epsilon 0 into E plus epsilon 0 into psi E into E. Okay. Now here from this equation epsilon 0 into E will take common. So we get epsilon 0 into E in bracket 1 plus psi E. Give equation number 3. But again capital D is equal to epsilon into E and which is equal to epsilon 0 into epsilon R into E. Here we know that the dielectric constant is nothing but the relative permeability and which is equal to epsilon divided by epsilon 0. So from this equation here we have taken epsilon is equal to epsilon R into epsilon 0. Understood? Now put this value, that is value of D, we just put in equation 3. We get epsilon 0 into E into epsilon R which is equal to epsilon 0 into E in bracket we can write 1 plus psi E bracket complete. Okay. Now throughout this equation epsilon 0 into E will get cancelled. Okay. And therefore remaining equation we can write epsilon R is equal to 1 plus psi E, or we can write instead of this epsilon R we can take K, or which is equal to 1 plus psi E. This K represents the dielectric constant and psi E is nothing but the electric susceptibility. Understood? And this is nothing but the relation between K and psi E. That is relation between the dielectric constant and electric susceptibility. Understood? So one more time we'll discuss about the types of polarization and types of dielectric materials. Here we can see there are three types of polarization. First one is the electronic polarization. This electronic polarization is also known as the atomic polarization. Understood? Here we can see in the absence of electric field, nucleus is at the center. Okay? And this electrons revolving around the nucleus. So this happens under the absence of electric field. Understood? Now when we apply the electric field to the material, then here we can see the nucleus moves away from the electric field and electron moves towards the applied electric field. Understood? Here we can see in the absence of applied electric field, the positively charged nucleus is surrounded by a spherical electron cloud with equal and opposite charge, and due to this reason outside the atom field is zero. Okay. Now when we apply the electric field, then electron cloud is distorted such that it is displaced in a direction opposite to that of the applied electric field. Okay. And hence the dipole moment is proportional to the magnitude of the field strength, and we can write mu E is equal to alpha E into capital E. So here this alpha E represent electronic polarizability constant, and E is nothing but the applied electric field. Now second type of polarization, that is ionic polarization. Now ionic polarization is simply nothing but the polarization between the positive and negative ions in a ionic crystal, called as ionic polarization. Now this type of polarization occurs only in ionic crystal like NaCl, KCl, etc. Okay. Now here this figure shows displacement of the ions due to the external electric field. Now first figure shows no applied field. Second figure shows with applied field. Understood? Now what happens without applied field? There is a no net polarization inside the material, because here what happened, the negative ions or the dipole moment of negative ions cancelled out with the positive ions, and due to this reason there is a no net polarization produced inside this material. Okay. Now when we apply the electric field to the material, then what happen, ions becomes displaced, which results into the induced polarization. So this is about the ionic polarization. Now third type of polarization is orientation polarization. So this type of polarization occurs in polar substance. Okay. Now here polar substance means what? A substance has permanent dipole moment. That substance is, or that material is nothing but the polar dielectric materials. Understood? For example, water, HCl, all these are the examples of the polar molecules. Okay. Now again, this type of substances produce dipole moment even in the absence of external electric field. Okay. So due to random orientation of the dipoles, the net dipole moment is zero. Here we can see in this figure. Now first figure shows the applied field is zero. Okay. In second figure, the applied field is weak, and in third figure, the applied field is very strong. Okay. Now what happened in first two figures? Here the arrangement of the dipoles, we can see they are randomly oriented, and hence net dipole moment is zero. Okay. And in last figure, when we apply the external field to the material, then the dipoles rotate about their axis of symmetry and try to align with the direction of the applied field. Understood? In first two cases, dipoles are randomly oriented, and hence the net polarization is zero. Okay. And in third figure, when we apply the external field, then what happen? This dipole try to align with the direction of the external field. Understood? Now this slide shows types of dielectric materials, which divides into three types, that is solid dielectrics, liquid dielectrics, and gaseous dielectrics. Okay. Now solid dielectrics divide into three types: elementary, non-polar, polar dielectrics. Now elementary dielectric means what? If the solid contains one type of atom, or we can say it exhibit only electronic polarization, called as elementary dielectrics. So these are the examples of the elementary dielectrics. Now second one is the non-polar ionic dielectrics. Now what happen in non-polar ionic dielectrics? There are more than one atoms are present here. Okay. But they have no dipole moments. So such type of material or dielectrics called as a non-polar ionic dielectrics. Here we can see the examples of non-polar ionic dielectrics. Okay. Now third type of dielectrics, that is polar dielectrics. Now such type of dielectrics, in this type of dielectrics what happen, all the polarizations are present, or we can say all type of atoms are present here. Okay. And this type of dielectrics have the permanent dipole moment, and hence it is known as a polar dielectrics. So here these are the examples. Now second type of dielectrics, that is liquid dielectrics, and which is divided into three types: mineral oils, synthetic oil, miscellaneous oil. Okay. Now these mineral oils obtain from the crude petroleum by distillation. Okay, and hence it is used as a coolant in a transformer. Okay, now second type of liquid dielectrics, that is synthetic oil. Now this synthetic oil is cheap and it is designed in laboratories. So it is used in high tension transformer for cooling purpose. Okay, and third type of liquid dielectrics, that is miscellaneous oil. So it is silicon liquid and vegetable oils. It has high cost compared to other oils. So it is used in high tension transformer. Okay, now last type of dielectric materials is gaseous dielectrics. Okay, that gaseous dielectrics divides into four types. First one is the air, second one is nitrogen, third one is sulfur hexafluoride, fourth one is the hydrogen. Understood? Now this air, we know that it is a naturally available gas. Okay, so its a dielectric constant is 1. It is used for electrical insulation. Okay, so ionization of air is 0 and resistivity is infinity. Okay, it is also used in long range electrical transmission and in air capacitor. Okay, now second type of gaseous dielectrics is nitrogen. Okay, so it is used to prevent oxidation when it is chemically inert. So it is also used in high voltage cables, transformers, etc. Now third type of gaseous dielectrics, that is sulfur hexafluoride. So it is better than air and nitrogen because its a dielectric strength is 2.3 times higher. Okay, so it is non-toxic, again non-flammable and chemically inert. So fourth type of gaseous dielectrics, that is hydrogen. Okay, it has better dielectric strength, so it is used in large generator, high voltage cables, etc. Now this slide shows temperature and frequency dependence of materials. Here we know that dielectric properties such as polarization, dielectric constant, dielectric loss, all these properties depends upon the applied frequency and temperature. Okay, now here electric field applied to dielectric material, then polarization of material is function of time. Hence we can write this equation, P of t is equal to P of 1 minus exponential minus t divided by tau r. Okay, now this tau r represent the relaxation time, and particularly for the polarization process, this relaxation time is the average time between the molecular collision under the application of the electric field. This P indicates maximum polarization attained due to the electric field. Now here we can see the space charge polarization occurs at very low frequency, and this is the slowest process compared to other polarization. Okay, now orientation polarization is faster than this space charge polarization. Ionic polarization occurs particularly this frequency range, and it is faster than orientation and space charge polarization. And electronic polarization occurs at 1015 Hz frequency, and it is faster than other types of polarization. Now temperature dependence effects are there. Now what happen in the presence of electric field? The alignment of dipoles are changed. Okay, so when the temperature increases, the dielectric constant decreases, because what happen here, the alignment of the dipoles are disrupted. Okay, one more thing, due to this what happen, the values of dielectric constant remains unchanged with the change in temperature. So here last one we discuss relation between dielectric constant K and dielectric susceptibility psi. For this, consider the equation of the electric displacement D is equal to epsilon 0 into E plus P. Here epsilon 0 indicates permittivity of free space, capital E is the applied electric field, and capital P is nothing but the polarization produced in a dielectrics. Okay, after that we know that polarization is equal to epsilon 0 into psi E into E. Now put these values in equation 1. Okay, so we get D is equal to epsilon 0 into E plus epsilon 0 psi E into E, and which is equal to epsilon 0 into E. Here what happened? The epsilon 0 into E, this term will take common. So we get this term, that is epsilon 0 into E, in bracket we can write 1 plus psi E, bracket complete. Give next equation, that is equation number 3. Okay, but again the value of D is nothing but the epsilon into capital E, and which is equal to epsilon 0 into epsilon r into E. Here we know that the dielectric constant K, or we can say that relative permeability epsilon r, is equal to epsilon divided by epsilon 0. So by using this equation we can write epsilon is equal to epsilon r into epsilon 0. So we get this equation. Understood? Now after that, put the value of D in equation 3. We get epsilon 0 into E into epsilon r, which is equal to epsilon 0 into E, in bracket we can write 1 plus psi E, bracket complete. Here throughout this equation epsilon 0 into E, this term will get cancelled. So remaining equation we can write epsilon r is equal to 1 plus psi E, or we can write K is equal to 1 plus psi E. So this K is nothing but the dielectric constant, and this psi E is nothing but the electric susceptibility. So this equation shows the relation between the dielectric constant and electrical susceptibility. Okay. Thank you.